We move on to teams for sale or potentially for sale. We know the Atlanta Hawks are. How much more attractive of a property, Chuck, are they now? They were considered potentially just to be the majority stake, but now they're 100% for sale.
So I'm representing the ownership group. I need to say that. But they are an attractive team. With 100% sale, you can count on a control premium usually because a new buyer would like to own the team outright. They've got a new local TV deal, which is outstanding. They've got a very young roster, and they've got a ton of salary room. So I think they're a very attractive franchise.
And then, of course, the national TV deals, et cetera. The idea of global appeal, as we've talked about, would be appealing to anybody coming in to buy that franchise or any other.
Yeah, and the beauty of Atlanta that people don't think about is it's 3 hours from many major cities. So if you took a compass, we had those in my days, and drew a circle around Atlanta, you'd see we're within 3 hours of New York, Chicago, Miami, obviously another number of big southern cities. And so it makes it very easy for a prospective owner to hop on a plane, get to Atlanta, get back in time. And so it makes it very attractive.
Good cop. Okay, I'm going to play bad cop here.
All right.
Everything that Chuck said, of course, is absolutely true. I'm going to say that based on what I'm hearing on the numbers between anywhere from 700 million to a billion, I'm going to say it's going to be under 900 million. And if I'm wrong, I'll come back here and fess up, excluding that $124 million bond on the arena. I'm going to knock that out. It'll be under 900 million because of this reason.
You know,
they're still having trouble selling tickets, and they got a great team.
That, but I will also now kind of audit myself from the first segment where I said maybe Ballmer paid too much for what the value of the team was at the time. He probably did, but isn't any team worth whatever value somebody's willing to pay for it?
Absolutely. So I'll take the over with that, with you on that, Mike. Yeah, I think there's a scarcity value in the NBA. The NBA is an exceedingly well-run league, very stable, long-term growth prospects. When you buy a team, you're buying a 30th of that league. You're not just buying the team itself. I think the Hawks have tremendous opportunity, and so, like I said, I'll take the over.
You know what? I'll actually agree with Chuck. You know why, Mike? I call it the eBay effect, right? Somebody that's buying the team doesn't want to pay over $1 billion, right? Then what do they do when they get to the finish line? I'll pay $1 billion one.
I guess
I'll pay $1 billion. What's the other one? I'll pay $1.5 billion.
It looks like I'm buying lunch here.
All right, let's move on now and talk about the potential sale of another team. We're hearing that the Brooklyn Nets, Mikhail Prokhorov, at least would be listening to offers. You're also involved in this to a certain extent, so we'll preface it by saying that. But is this a team, as we've looked at the valuations in our first segment, that's going to get a premium as well?
Hey, Brooklyn, New York is hot. Brooklyn, New York is hot. That goes to the cool factor, right? Yeah, I think that Brooklyn will extract a substantial premium. I think if the entire team is for sale, they'll get a healthy premium. Mike's number is probably pretty close. If the arena were to be for sale as well, it would be a pretty ridiculous number, exceedingly high. You know, there's only one New York, and Brooklyn has become pretty popular.
Did you want to play bad cop again here?
Of course. I know you're going to take Chuck's side again, so I might as well make it two lunches. I would just say, look, I would be a little cautious with this team. I unequivocally agree with Chuck that the trophy premium could be big in Brooklyn, approaching almost an L.A.-type premium. Because don't forget, in L.A. with the Clippers, Ballmer paid $400 million more than the next highest bid, which was Oprah Winfrey's group. I don't know it would be that much of a premium here, but this is a team that's losing a lot of money. After this season, they still have one more year of a very high salary cap figure, which that tax that they're paying on their payroll is a big reason why they're losing money. So you got to be willing to have deep pockets and hold on if you're looking to get money back from a $1.5 billion purchase or something higher.
Now, as a buyer, and we've talked about a lot of these NBA teams are making money, if the Nets are losing money, as Mike suggested, if I'm a buyer and I'd have to be a billionaire, would it bother me or would I look at it like, look, I'll make it up somewhere else?
I mean, any buyer is going to look at the current financial situation. I think most buyers, when they're looking at these clubs, are counting on capital appreciation, notwithstanding current operating losses. So if I'm a buyer looking at the NBA, again, I'm looking at a long-term, stable growth equity. And there's a lot of money in New York, just like L.A., substantial wealth, hedge fund, private equity, real estate communities. I do think there's somebody out there that would love to get their hands on an NBA team in New York. New York teams rarely trade hands. It's been a long time since the last one, so this really will be a trophy asset.
Let's move on now and talk about the NFL in Los Angeles. Is it going to happen? If so, when? So, Chuck, I'll come back to you with that. Roger Goodell, the commissioner of the NFL, has already come out and said 2015 there will be no team in L.A. Do you think that it's inevitable that there will be?
Yeah, but I think it's a matter of when, not if. I think, look at L.A., like New York, 12 million people, second biggest media market, substantial corporate wealth. 32 of the Fortune 500 companies are headquartered there. You've got the entertainment community. It's obviously a great media market. I think that you're going to see the NFL in L.A. maybe not next year, certainly not next year, but I think by 16, there's a strong likelihood.
All right. Now, Rams owner Stan Kroenke, as we know, owns property out there, has said he'll build a stadium. Hasn't quite said if he'll move yet, if he'll stay in St. Louis. What do you think about that, Mike?
Oh, I think he's moving, Bob. He will build a stadium. I think he'll be one of two teams that currently exist that will move here. Here's what I think the NFL is going to do. I think two teams out of St. Louis being one of them for sure, then either San Diego or Oakland will move, and they'll have two teams in one stadium. Kroenke will build it. The Rams now in St. Louis, the municipality is trying to come up with a bid. I think it's going to be too little, too late. And then I think later on, the NFL will be in the catbird seat. It will expand, and those cities that have been vacated by teams that have moved to L.A., they'll say, hey, want to pay $2 billion? You can have an expansion team, and that's when they'll add two teams.
What team, Michael, by the way, do you think is most likely to move? You've mentioned those.
I think it's going to be the Rams, and I think it's going to be probably San Diego.
Okay.
And I think, because I think Oakland stands, there's more real estate development opportunities, I think, in Oakland. I think it can get done there. It's a better market.
What about just expansion, Chuck? What about expanding two teams into L.A.?
Look, expansion would be brilliant. If you look at the price that the Clippers and the Dodgers have fetched recently, you could expect a very, very healthy price for an expansion team. I think if the NFL expands for scheduling purposes, they do it by two teams. That money goes right into the owner's pockets, and so that's an interesting and compelling possibility.
And don't forget, when they let the Browns move from Cleveland to Baltimore, they then gave an expansion team to Cleveland. That's why I kind of see that scenario playing out here. Move to currently existing teams, then give the teams that those cities that were vacated the opportunity to improve, build stadiums, and then buy an expansion team. And what are we talking? Don't forget, we're talking about an expansion fee of $2 billion. A relocation fee could be $250, $275 million. So that's not peanuts either.